Opportunity is youth. My name is Sarah. I'm the co-founder of 4 companies. One makes briquettes, 2 makes animal feeds, the 3rd one makes soap, and the last one makes hydropower.
The opportunity is Africa with Looney Lebez on Africa Business Radio, towards a profitable Africa.
How does one person do 4 companies? These are 4 companies at the same time, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so we got to tour this today. You can go online and watch a video seeing the headquarters with 3 of those companies in it.
Yes.
How does one person wind up doing 4 companies? Walk us through how that happened.
Yeah, I was a student in Kisii University and I could afford school fees. So in the Kisii University, there's a program where even if you are not a university student or you are an outsider from the community, there's a program they have where they can train you on entrepreneurship. I joined that program with Mr. Elias Mabiria, who has been the mentor since I started this project. He has been mentoring all these projects, and I did all these 4 projects for the purpose of choosing the best one, which I can go with, and the best is the hydropower, which I'm going to take.
Okay, so how long ago was the first company?
The first company started back in the year 2016.
All right, so we're talking 3 years ago from the time of recording this, and you didn't do it yourself, right? There were some other students involved?
Yeah, we were 4 students in Kisii University who also had no school fees, and then we came together. We went to the incubation room where we met our mentor, Mr. Elias Mabiri. He mentored us on those projects, and still he's still mentoring us on this project.
Okay, so you were doing briquettes, and yeah. How many people together make briquettes?
In briquette making, we started with 2, and in the process of making these briquettes, the other three came in. We are also all the 5 doing briquettes, and we have a plan of leaving one project, leaving this briquette project to one of our students.
So you're really incubating companies. So you helped make this one, and one of your co-founders is going to go run that.
Yes.
And then there was the soap company was next?
Yeah, the soap making is the next company. We are also releasing one of the students to go with the soap making project.
And the 3rd one seems to be the biggest in terms of equipment and size. And so what's that one?
Yeah, that's animal feeds.
So you take, what is in animal feed? Most of the listeners here don't grow animals.
Yeah, in animal feeds, we make feeds for chicken and cows. And we make them from the crops which are grown in the local community.
Great. And then there's a giant mill that turns this into feed, grinds everything up, mixes it all together.
Yes.
How did you get that?
The animal feed mixer was donated by the government. And this came about when one of the women representative in the community, she was told that we have some young women who are fighting who are fighting for a living in the community. So when she passed it there, we told her that we need a machine which we can make the feeds to serve the community, because in the community, the farmers in the community, when they are looking for feeds, they go more than 20 kilometers looking for the feeds. So we convinced the government that if you can give us the machine, we can solve the problem in this community.
Yeah, and that machine's got to be worth at least $50,000.
Yes.
Yeah. But then the story you told me was the problem is that the feed machine, the charcoal machine, and even the soap machine, they all run on electricity.
Yes.
So how reliable is the electricity around here?
I think the reason as to why we come up with another project of making hydropower is because most of the time we have 7 days in the week and we work 6 days in the week. Out of 6 days, we might have the electricity 2 to 3 days having electricity, and some other days we don't have electricity.
And no electricity, no feed, no money.
No money, yeah. Right?
And no electricity, no charcoal, no money.
No money, yeah.
And there's also another business in that same building, which is growing, incubating chicks, baby chicks.
Yeah, baby chicks. Yeah.
And if there's no electricity, the eggs die.
The eggs die, the chicks die. Yeah,
so one key we've seen throughout history is the more power people have, the easier it is to grow the economy.
Yeah.
Right, so the story Sarah told me is that she just saw we need power.
Yeah, we need power.
And if you listen a few episodes ago to Elias, he was the one who talked about Biera Energy.
Yeah.
I met him first, even though it was Sarah's project. So he explained the needs of electricity and how we can make it here in Kisii County.
Yes.
With water.
Yes.
And again, you can go watch online, go on YouTube, yes. Search for Biera Energy, B-I-E.
BieraEnergy.com.
I don't remember how to spell it.
Biera, B-I-E-E-R.
Okay. You can go online and search for Biera Energy. Yeah. It's B-I-E-E-R-A.
Yeah.
Right? Biera.com.
Yeah.
But meanwhile, let's actually step back and talk a little bit more about you. So you are not quite done with school yet.
Yeah.
Yeah. So remind us what school you're at and how many students are there?
I'm in Kisii University, where we have 16,000 students.
So out of 16,000 students, how many other students have started three companies?
We are five.
Just five of you. Yeah. And you are all young.
Yeah, we are all young.
And you're all women.
Yeah, we are all women.
Okay. And how many other students in the student body have started even one company?
Nobody.
So what makes you different? What makes you five different from the rest?
I think the reason as to why we are unique in Kisii University is because we want to take control of our lives so that we can make a living through ourselves, not to depend from our parents. I think we have proved that we can do that, and we are proving that the youth can do this. And that's why I say the opportunity is youth.
You're listening to Africa Business Radio, where you get up-to-date insights on the Africa business landscape. Log on to www.africabusinessradio.com. Your favorite shows are available as podcasts. Download them on our website and mobile app. Africa Business Radio, towards a profitable Africa.